Tinley. I'm captain of the cheer squad. My friends consider me the glue that holds group together. Oh, did I mention I made new cheer? I need control in my life. Though no one notices but I do, it's okay, but I don't think I'm pretty. My friend told me about this diet, and before you know it, I had an eating disorder. It's what I regret most in my life, and now I can't stop.
Hello, and welcome to BDTV Tinley Park News February edition. I'm Eric.
And I'm Chansey. Let's see what's happening in the world. Having graduated in 2011, Sarah Nagengast is continuing to succeed in her education career. She's recently been added to the Dean's List for Academic Achievement by the College of Engineering at the University of Iowa, an honor that's reserved for those who maintain at the minimum a 3.5 grade point average during the semester. She's a prime example of what Tinley hopes all their students will strive to be.
To start off the new year, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration says that in Illinois, all passengers must be wearing a seatbelt at all times. More than 15,000 lives are saved each year in the United States. The new seatbelt law is not just that the people in the front have to wear them, but everyone in the car is required to wear a seatbelt. Don't forget to tighten your seatbelts.
Attention all freshmen, sophomores, and juniors. The Illinois High School Association, known as the IHSA, has passed a new law for the fall of 2012. If you plan on playing a sport or participating in an activity, you must pass 5 academic classes in order to participate. This is an early reminder, so start now and get organized.
Though there hasn't been much snow this winter, you could be walking through a winter wonderland at the end of February thanks to the Turnabout Dance. The dance is scheduled to take place on February 25th from 7 to 10 o'clock p.m. Ticket prices are to be announced, so be sure to listen to morning announcements.
Though the Tinley Park area is small, field reporter Abby shows us that there are plenty of places to dig in.
Getting a bite to eat can turn into quite the hassle for Tinley students. But it doesn't have to be. Even right down Oak Park, there are restaurants, cafes, and even creameries.
With high gas prices and the weather making traffic worse and worse, going out to eat can turn into a problem.
I pay $40 to fill up my tank.
But with so many places to eat, why set out of Tinley? There's a gourmet cafe, 4 Chinese restaurants, 3 creameries, 4 actual restaurants, 2 pizzerias, and a bakery open at 5 a.m. And if you're not adventurous, there are plenty of brand name restaurants, right? But they can't compare for prices.
That's 2 brownies, 2 muffins, and a cookie, all for under $5. The prices cannot be beat.
So there's really no reason to go out of our way when there are so many places to eat, right in our own little town. For more information on these places, go to www.digdivedine.blogspot.com. Now, all this talk of food has made me hungry. So back to you in the studio. I'm gonna eat.
My stomach's grumbling right now, actually.
The sports teams will be working hard on the 11th and 12th. The annual fishing show kicks off at 8 in the morning. Footballers help in setup, cheerleaders handle stock, and swimmers sell cod and catfish. The high school attracts almost 143 vendors, making it the largest fundraiser for athletics. Come out and support your fellow Titans.
The Tinley Park Titan boys basketball team is 9-8 so far this season. One of the best games of the month was against the Eisenhower Cardinals. Titans won 93-92 with 4 seconds left in the game. John Calhoun scored the points that they needed to win that night in South Suburban Crossover. Keep up the good work, Titans. From the basketball court to the wrestling mat, here's Chansey with more.
Titan Boys Wrestling started their season off great this year. For the first time ever, the Titans won the District Quad. They also took first place in the Plainfield East Invite. The Titans had 7 placers in the Lincoln and Reed Custer invites. The wrestling team had 4 standout wrestlers this year. Senior Larry Lannon and Josh Guttner, junior Dan Kuricki, and sophomore David McDonald. Great job, Titan wrestlers.
On February 10th, Daniel Radcliffe returns with a new kind of magic. In the movie The Woman in Black, Radcliffe is a young lawyer leaving his son to go to a village where the adults hide their children. The film is a horror and thriller, giving Radcliffe a new adult feel.
A group of hackers, commonly known as Anonymous or Anon, aren't going to allow SOPA and PIPA to pass without a fight. After the takedown of Mega Upload, a site notorious for online piracy, Anon struck back by taking down sites owned by supporters of SOPA and PIPA, along with government sites such as the FBI webpage, by posting a link to these sites on Twitter, thus overloading their servers. Could your favorite site be next?
We've got Spirit.
Yes, we do.
We've got Spirit. How about you? On February 22nd at 6 p.m. at Oak Forest High School, the district will hold its first ever Spirit Shakedown. The competition will be among all 4 schools in the category of School Spirit, Dress Dash, Relay Race, Guy Cheer, Tug of War, and a Teacher Volleyball Game. The cost for entry goes to benefit the Get Together We Cope Foundation. For more details or to sign up to participate, contact Ms. Bumpus.
Thank you for watching. Join us next month for our March edition. Check us out at www.bdtv228.net. Or like us on Facebook at Bremen District Television. For Eric, I'm Chansey. See ya!
Video games are changing kids, teens, and even adults' lives all over the world.
A recent poll from ComScore states that there are more than 217 million people worldwide that play video games.
I'd say anywhere between ages of 5 and 50.
Is the age that most people would think, but in America, the average age is only 33.
And there's the Xbox Kinect. You can get yourself kind of physically fit there. If it begins to be too much of Xbox or any type of video game system, that could kind of destroy your social life.
So turn off your video games and let's get outside more. Well, Max, let's go for a walk.
Oh,